Hi, today we discuss about the knowledge management value chain. So, knowledge management refers to the set of business processes developed in an organization to create, store, transfer, and apply knowledge. Knowledge management increases the ability of the organizations to learn from its environment and to incorporate knowledge into its business processes. Following figure illustrates the five value adding steps in the knowledge management. So, value chain, each stage in the value chain adds value to raw data and information as they are transformed into usable knowledge. In the figure, informed systems activities are separated from related management and organizational activities. With information systems activities on the top of the graphic and organizational and management activities. So now we discuss about crisis management. What is crisis management? So an individual, an organization, a government, or the global economy at any point of time might face troubles. So this may come any form and can devastate the present circumstances and can lead to difficult situations. Such occurrences are often termed as crises. It is therefore defined as a major, unpredictable, and upsetting event that intimidates to harm. Even though crisis is an unpredictable form of event, but it is not unanticipated. Crisis is a threat to an organization, an unexpected element, and short periods of risk in any organizations. For an organization's crisis can be illustrated as an anomalous and uncharacteristic situations. So preparations which is beyond the control of an organization and also threatens to impact their operations. So now we discuss about emotional intelligence in the workplace. At the workplace, the ability to exercise clear and sound judgment in situations that the job role presents solely depends on the emotional intelligence. Employees' processes, it encompasses the ability to manage their own impulse, cope with change, effectively communicate with others and solve problems, and being able to make use of humor to diffuse a tense situation. Such employees have the ability to empathize with others, are optimistic in the face of downturn, and they are effective in resolving customer complaints. Therefore, emotional intelligence plays a vital role in separation top performers from weak ones at the workplace. Entrepreneurial marketing. So, entrepreneurship or entrepreneurial marketing is the combination of two discrete management areas existing as distinct disciplines. Entrepreneurship and marketing have emerged to capture the several facets of marketing that are often not explained by existing traditional marketing theories and concepts. Definition of both marketing and entrepreneurship differ considerably, and we cannot expect that one single definition of entrepreneur marketing will cover everything. A contemporary definitions that meets the present scope in which entrepreneurial marketing is defined as the proactive identifications and exploitations of opportunities for acquiring and retaining profitable customers through innovative approaches to risk management, resource leveraging, and value creation. Recently, entrepreneurial marketing has gained popularity in the marketing and entrepreneurship disciplines. So now we discuss about BCM, that is business continuity management. So as ounce of prevention of worth a pound of cure, according to Benjamin Franklin, the entire business around the world are exposed to risks or disruptions, whether it is from a fire equipment failure, natural disasters, communication failure, economy downturn, or an act of terrorism. There can be hardly superior hazard to any organizations than recessions. The organizations experienced more disruptions than ever in the past years. These disruptions can ruin the organizations or make it difficult to survive. This is where business continuity management, that is BCM, plays integral role to smoothly run the business without any interruption. So business continuity management is very important for the endurance of the social entrepreneurship. So now we discuss about what is social entrepreneurship and its meaning and challenges of social entrepreneurship and success factors of it. The rapid growth of the marketing is constantly changing our lives. As a result, entrepreneurs are played the important role in the market as they are seen as agent of changes, which the change is economically based. The implications are far-reaching, affecting other aspects of society, such as social, cultural, and political. That is why the entrepreneur is willing to take the responsibility and taking business risk to create and expand their businesses to order to explore more opportunities, which the goods or services are fulfills customers' demand and preference. So entrepreneurs seems to be the starter, and they also assume the role of manager in the organizations. So now we discuss about the need for corporate entrepreneurship. The corporate entrepreneurships is an important element in large and medium organizations. So entrepreneurship exists within the organizations. It plays important role in the organizational economic development. Entrepreneurship leads not only to new ventures, it leads other innovative activities and orientations such as development of new product, technologies, services, strategies, and competitive posture in the organizations. In good or bad economic times, companies seek innovations to remain competitive. Entrepreneurs are more intelligent and have ability to perceive the big picture. They are self-motivated and optimistic. These people are action-oriented and move quickly to get things done. Corporate entrepreneur is a person who focuses on innovations and creativity to transform dreams into profitable reality. So now we discuss about what is entrepreneurship, its definition and meaning, and features of entrepreneurship. So in 1992, the American Heritage Dictionary acknowledged the popular use of a new word, entrepreneur. So it means a person within a large corporation who takes direct responsibility for turning an idea into a profitable finished product through assertive risk taking and innovation. So entrepreneurship is known as the practice of an corporate management style that integrates risk taking and innovation approaches, as well as the reward and motivational techniques that are more traditionally thought of as being the province of entrepreneurship. They are entrepreneurs who catch hold of a new idea for a product, service, or process of work to bring this idea functions within the framework of the organizations. So now we discuss about the definition of food traceability, definition, meaning, and advantages of it. Food traceability and safety is an up and coming trend with the slow food, organic and natural movements for more consumers are wanting to know where their food is coming from. Food producers also are making food traceability to trend because each producers want to know who they can point fingers at when the customer claims that they have become sick from a producer food. For most producer, traceability is just one element of any supply management or quality, safety and control system. Tracking an apple from the tree to your mouth is something that each producer needs to know. They need to know where that apple was to make sure that the apple did not go anywhere. So it should not have been. So now we discuss about open innovation versus closed innovation. Open and closed innovation, their definition. So innovation is one of the most important catalysts to the sustainable organization growth and performance. The term of innovation is already used over the century ago, and innovation meaning to focus on the changes or improvement made by the organization, either to their product, services, processes, and paradigm. So innovation is the use of new technological and market knowledge to offer a new product or service the customers want, and the new product must new. Lower cost and the attributes of the product are improved with the attributes that never exist in the market before. The concept of innovation also defined as the processes of making changes of something established by introducing something new that adds value to customers and contributes the new knowledge store of the organization. So now we discuss about benefits of corporate retreats in organizations. So corporate retreats can be any type of, such as at sport retreats or seminar style retreat. There are to promote a feeling of teamwork and to build a better understanding among company employees. Corporate retreats can also help employees gain some problem-solving skills that lead to better teamwork and better overall productivity. These team-building activities focus on events where everyone has to work together to reach a common goal. The example are river rafting, rock climbing, mountaining climbing, everyone hiking blindfolded while holding on the same rope. So team scavengers hunt, friendly competitions between company department, etc. Corporate retreats can be customized to fit the company's need. So now we discuss about the key performance of indicators, KPIs, meaning and type of its. Key performance indicators. So key performance indicators are a type of performance measurement tools. It allows management to measure the performance of a company in a certain area, such as profitable. KPIs can help a team to work together to achieve a common set of measurable goals. They provide and a very quick way to seeing the actual performance of a goal or strategic objectives. Key performance indicators are most used to monitor and operations or to measure, focusing in the aspects of organizational performance, which are most critical for organizations' current and future success. Key performance indicators, KPIs, are used in order to assess the company's performance in their business units, divisions, department, and employees of the company. So that's all for these videos, my friends. My humble request is, if you like my videos, please, please share, support, and subscribe my MBA channel. I need your support, my friends. Thanks a lot for watching my videos.